Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Let's get on to solving 5 prelims question for prelims 2020 for day 8. Alright, question number 1. With reference to democracies, consider the following statements. Democracies ke baare mein hume do statements given hai. Number 1. All countries which hold elections are democratic republic. Sabhi nations jidhar bhi elections hota hai, kya wo democratic hai? Second. All countries that are democratic politics have a written constitution. जिन सारी countries में democratic politics है, क्या उनमें लिखा हुआ संविधान है? So let's look at the options here. Number 1, 1 only, 2 only, both or none. So please pause a bit and try to come up with the right answer. It's really important and a simple question. So let's see the answer now. So none of these statements are correct. These are so obvious. Number 1, why would all countries which are holding elections be democratic republic or polities? For example, China is there, wherein elections are held periodically, but still China is not a true democracy. China's case can be a little controversial, but we can look at North Korea as a country. Even in North Korea, elections are held periodically, and North Korea in fact call itself as a democratic republic, but then it is not. So yes, not all countries which hold elections are democratic polities. That's it. Second is, all countries that are democratic polities have written constitution. Not correct. We know United Kingdom or UK, they are indeed democracies, democratic country, but they do not have written constitution. So that's it. So we got the answer, neither one nor two. It's really simple. Let's get on to next one. So here we are to talk about conditions or situations. So let's read the question. Which of the following situations can be considered proper for the imposition of president's rule in a state? So what all are the conditions? Number 1, maladministration in the state. Kya hai maladministration? We do not know, but maladministration in the state, is it one of the criteria to call a president rule as proper? Second, a government is deliberately acting against the constitution. All right third is, a constitutional direction of the central government is disregarded by the state government. We're talking about constitutional direction here, and not just any direction. So what can be the answer here? So let's look at the options. Number 1 is 2 only, 1 and 3 only, 2 and 3 all. So these options making is just a formality. We should be knowing the answer either way. So herein, in the year 1994, Supreme Court of India came up with the S.R. Bommai case, wherein Supreme Court categorically put forward the cases wherein the imposition of president's rule would be proper and the cases where it would be improper. It's right there in the Lakshmikant. Number 1 is incorrect. What is maladministration in the state? There is no definition, there is no fixed criteria to define what exactly is it. So this is not our case to impose a precedent rule in a state. So option 1 is gone. Yes, second is correct, that if a government is deliberately apni marzi se jaan boojh ke acting against the constitution, constitution is supreme, no government can act against the constitution. So yes, if a state government is acting against the constitution, president can impose a precedent rule. Second is, number 3 is also correct, that if a constitutional direction of central government is deliberately disregarded by the government, so yes, then also precedent rule can be imposed. So this is really, really important. Sometimes we end up not giving due credit to simple or easy questions and we make mistakes. So do not make mistakes here. We are done. 1 is incorrect, 2 and 3 are correct. So we got our answer C here. That's it. Let's move on to the next question now, which is again very simple, pure factual. Either we know this or we don't. Which of the following committees of the Constituent Assembly were headed by the Sardar Patel? So Sardar Patel ne kaun sari committees ko jo Constituent Assembly mein thi unko head kiya tha? Number 1, Provincial Constitution Committee. Second is Advisory Committee on Fundamental Rights, Minorities and Tribal and Excluded Areas. Third is States Committee. So idhar option padhne ka bhi kuch khas zarurat nahi hai. We should be knowing the answer. So answer is 1 and 2 only. So Sardar Patel headed a Provincial Constitution Committee and the Committee on Fundamental Rights and Minorities and Tribals. States Committee was headed by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, as it's been written right over here. Again, we just have to memorize this, and it's really, really important, especially in some of the state services exam, these types of questions can be asked. So please memorize Provincial Constitution Committee and Committee on Fundamental Rights and all this by Sardar Patel, and States Committee by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So let's move on to the fourth question now, which is about preventive detention. Consider the following statements regarding preventive detention. What do we mean by preventive detention? It simply means a person is detained even before one has committed any crime. So crime नहीं commit करे इससे पहले हमने उसको detain कर लिया. Number one, the constitution has authorized only the parliament to make laws regarding preventive detention. Is it so? Or can the state governments too or the state legislatures too can make a law on the preventive detention? पहला statement यही है. Second है, a person can be detained indefinitely under preventive detention laws upon periodic review and authorization by the central government. तो एक इंसान preventive detention law के तहत indefinitely हमेशा के लिए detention में रह सकता है, provided कि central government थोड़े थोड़े समय बाद उसका review करती रहे. So पहला statement भी simple है कि क्या parliament ही इस पर कानून बना सकता है. So please try to think it through and try to come up with the right answer. It's really important. So let's see the answer now. Both of these statements are incorrect because there are categorical division of these law making when it comes to preventive detention. So the parliament can make laws onto the preventive detention when it deals with these subjects: defense, foreign affairs and security. An exclusive authority parliament of India is having. So the subjects are important: defense, foreign affairs and the security of India. And both parliament as well as the state legislature can make law onto preventive detention on these subjects. Security of state, here we're talking about security of India and here we're talking about security of a state. Punjab ke security ko koi threat hoga to Punjab ka government bhi preventive detention law ke according kuch kanun bana sakta hai. Second is the maintenance of public order and the maintenance of supplies and services essential to the community. So we just have to memorize these things now. Ek point ke baad samajhne wala kuch hai nahi. To parliament ka defense, foreign affairs, security of India, that too exclusive authority. And concurrently means both parliament as well as state legislature, we have security of state, maintenance of public order, maintenance of supplies and services essential to the community, that's it. So none of these statements are correct. We have seen the option one only. Let's talk about two. Here we are saying that a person can be detained indefinitely. So how could a person be detained indefinitely in a democratic country, right? It's so unreasonable. And also explanation here is right here that a person can be detained at max for 3 months. After that, it has to be, the case has to be forwarded to an advisory board. An advisory board would comprises of what? Government? No. It would consist of judges of the High Court. So that's it. All these statements are incorrect here. It's talking about indefinite period of preventive detention. No, it's just 3 months. And then it is talking about periodic review, but by the authorization of central government. No, periodic review is there, but under an advisory board, and that advisory board consists of judges of High Court. So all these things are correct, and this is right there in Article 22, which talks about preventive detention, and this is applicable to both citizens as well as aliens. So this right is not just to citizen of India but to aliens as well. It's really important. So please pause a bit, try to read this slide and try to memorize each and every point. Every point of this slide is important. It's 3 months, it's advisory boards, it's judges of High Court, and that's it. Let's move on to the last question now. Which of the following is are correct with reference to functions of a constitution? So 11th class ka polity ki book mein seedha seedha functions given hai. So this question basically talks about functions that's been written over there. But either way, even if we haven't read the polity book, we should be able to answer this. Number one, no, we are talking about just the constitution of India. We basically broadly talking about constitution, theek hai, uska kya function hai. Number one, it facilitates coordination among the members of society. Definitely correct. So constitution coordination to facilitate karega. I don't think we really need to explain this. It ensures the absence of monarchy. Is it so? We'll see. Is it so or not? It places limitations on the power of the government. Definitely. Constitution is having fundamental rights, and fundamental rights are basically a limitation on the powers of the government. Fourth is, it enables a government to fulfill the aspirations of the society. Definitely, it's correct, and I really don't think we should be explaining point number fourth or point number three. But point number second is incorrect, and this needs a little bit of explanation. Constitution does not ensure that there would definitely be absence of a monarchy. Even British has a constitution, although it's unwritten form, but still a constitution is a constitution, and British is a monarchical form of government. So yes, statement two cannot be true. It does not ensure there would be an absence of monarchy at all. There could be a monarchical constitution as well. Indian is a republican constitution, but then there can be a monarchical constitution as well as, right? So yes, all these, even a 10 marker can be asked, what are the function of a constitution? Maybe not in UPSC, but in certain state exams. So it facilitates coordination, it ensures them, it places limitation on the power of government, it enables the government to fulfill the aspiration of the society. So second is incorrect, second is here, and then C becomes our answer, that is 1, 3, and 4. So option making is just a formality. We should be knowing all the things either way. So we are done with the five questions for day 8 for prelims 2020, and I really am looking forward for your feedback in terms of any constructive criticism or in terms of any suggestion that you want me to incorporate in my lectures, and really would be doing that. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.